Okay, so this is a radical equation, and it's already set up for us to square both sides. Why? How do I know? It's because the radical is already isolated from the rest. So then I'm just getting ready to square. When I square the left-hand side, I get? When I square the right-hand side, I get? Which is? Perfect. This is a quadratic equation, so then I have to set everything equal to 0. X squared stays. I'm adding x to both sides, and I get negative x. And I'm subtracting 13 from both sides, and I get negative 12. If you forgot to write 0, then you couldn't continue. So you have to write 0. The quadratic equation has to be set equal to 0. And now we will factor. And I saw many of you did very well. Negative 4 and 3, x equals 4, and x equals negative 3. When you went back and checked, this worked, and this one not. Okay, any questions? Yes, please. But you copied it from here, here. Okay, just one half an inch. Okay. Okay, any questions on this? This is a contract that we made a month and a half ago. Yeah. So now it's already past the middle of the semester. I'm going to say it's the contract. Yes.
Can you re-say the contract again? Just was it a squared?
Yes, I will.
I'm sorry. Like, I wrote it down, but I lost it somewhere.
Okay, let me show you where they are in the book, because I think that that's better. Maybe you should read this just in case. Okay, can you please stop? Please, can you please stop? Yes.
I know the contract is just that I just need to
Okay. Okay. So a plus b, everything squared, is a squared plus 2ab plus b squared.
Okay.
Now, if the middle term is negative, then you have the middle term to be negative. And also we have a plus b times a minus b, which is a squared minus b squared. And we use this a lot in rationalizing and dividing complex numbers. So these, I'm not going to say anything about them anymore. It's past the middle of the semester. We've been discussing this for a month and a half. Is that agreed? Is that okay? So when I say contract, you have to look it up. If you still have difficulties with it, please stay after class so I can help you with this now, so we don't have to talk about it anymore. Good. I'll be more than happy to sit down with anyone who needs help on this. Okay. So now let's go back to chapter 9 and review chapter 9 for the test on Monday. So in chapter 9, we have three sections. We have 9.2 and through 9.4. And I'm looking at the review for chapter 9, which starts, it's a short review. It starts on page 582 and runs through page 583. And there is also a chapter 9 test there. So let's choose, I'm going to list some problems from section 9.2. So problems start with problem 7. So from number 7 through 52. Because section 9.1 was already covered in the previous test. So a typical example would be number 12. So in number 12, the absolute value of 3x minus 2 plus 6 equals 10. I cannot stress enough, please redo all your quizzes, all your homework with solutions. I will post solutions for this homework that you turn in today. And please do my LEPS Plus homework before the test if you are considering my LEPS Plus. Okay, 1 minute on this. And then we'll do it together. Can anyone get us started? So the absolute value of 3x minus 2 equals 4. Okay, next step. Very good. So what do I write? 3x minus 2 equals 4. Or 3x minus 2 equals negative 4. Okay, let's solve this. Please give me the answers. So 3x equals 6, x equals 2, I agree with x equals 2. And 3x equals negative 2, or x equals negative 2/3. Do we all agree with these two? Solution set negative 2/3 and 2. Solution set. Correct, everyone?
You have to write solution set.
Not necessarily. If you just write this and you box it in, then I know that this, you know where to stop and it's done. That's fine. But normally, but it's fine if you just write that. Then let's say number 18 as another example. X minus 3 in absolute value equals x plus 5 in absolute value. Can anyone give us the two options that we need to start with so everyone can see them? X minus 3 equals x plus 5, and the other option is? Very good. Don't forget parentheses. Very good. Okay, so what is the first option? So x minus 3 equals negative x minus 5, or 2x equals negative 2, or x equals negative 1. Do we agree or disagree, or we have questions on this? When I subtract x from both sides, I get 0. Is this okay? Do we understand what's happening here? Okay, mm-hmm. So this was section 9.2. Not sufficient to say I'm ready with 9.2. You still have to go back and work on these. Section 9.3, let's start with number 20. 6 plus 4x in absolute value greater than or equal to 10. 1 minute. when you are ready, can anyone say something about this so everyone is on the right track? Yes. Yes, I agree. It's the harder of the two problems.
So it's,
yes, I'm ready.
So 6 plus 4 is equal to 10.
I cannot change the inequality symbol.
The point. Yeah.
Very good. These are the two inequalities we need to solve. Very good. Thank you. Can anyone give us the first one?
X.
So first it's 4x greater than or equal to 4, which means x greater than or equal to? Do we all agree with the first one, greater than or equal to 1? X greater than or equal to 1? Okay, the second one is 4x less than or equal to negative 16, which makes x less than or equal to negative 4. Now I have to write the solution and it has to have the union. Can anyone dictate the union? We read from left to right. Careful. Correct. With a bracket. Very good. Do we all agree with this? Any questions, please? Okay. I'd like to look at now at let's say 24. 6x minus 5 in absolute value less than or equal to 5. Okay, 1 minute. Can anyone tell me what to write as the next step? Do you all agree with this step? Next step, please. Good. So here, here, and here. Good. Final step. Good. Here. In the middle. And 10 divided by 6, 5 over 3. In interval notation, x in. What type of symbols, left and right? Very good. What about 23? The absolute value of 6x minus 5 is less than or equal to negative 1. Okay, any suggestions?
This is the easy version.
So what do I write?
-4.
Okay. Say it again.
-4.
So before you say anything, what type of number is this? What type of number?
Positive.
Good. What type of number is this?
Negative.
So if I come in one day and I tell you that a positive number is less than or equal to a negative number, what will you say? Right, so how many solutions does this inequality have? None. You have to read before you start doing anything. Please read what you're asked to do. Look at the equation or inequality or whatever it is before you decide, right? Okay. Next problem. Let's look at problem 38. And this is 4x minus y less than or equal to 0 and 3x minus 2y greater than or equal to negative 5. We're asked to solve such a system, and we know the only way to solve such a system is by graphing. Thank you. By graphing. So let's start. 3 minutes. Say it again. 4x minus y less than or equal to 0, 3x minus 2y greater than or equal to negative 5. Let me know if you need help.
Still, you work on the problem and learn from your mistakes. Then you can. I wouldn't discard them ever until you're done with math. But if you want to, you can. But I recommend keep them so you can learn from. So you know what I stressed in that particular class or section. Okay. Please.
What is the first step? This is not a function. We don't write a domain for this. I cannot simplify and I won't waste my time with that. It's not possible anyway. Yes. So the first step is I have to write the equation. I'm not changing the inequality into an equation, but I need to graph the equation. So now, when x is 0, how much is y? So 0, 0 is the first ordered pair. I know now that the line passes through the origin. So what do I do next? When x is 1, plug it in and give me y, please. Y is? 4. Do you have any questions how we got that? So when x is 1, phi is 0, move y to the other side, y equals 4. Is that okay? So 1 comma 4.
That's all I need. So 0 comma 0 and 1 comma 4. But now I have to decide whether this will be a solid line or a dotted line.
Solid line.
Solid line.
I write the name on it. This is not the inequality, this is just the equation. Now I pick a point anywhere you want. Let's say I want to pick this point. Can you give me this point? Just make one up. 6 comma 0. Excellent. So let's plug it in. 6 and 0. 4 times 6 is 24. 24 minus 0 is 24. So this point gives us 24 less than or equal to 0. No. True or false?
False.
False. So I have to shade in the opposite. Now this area, including points on the line, is 4x minus y less than or equal to 0. Next step, please. Right. So then I have 3x minus 2y equals negative 5. When x is 0, y is? Perfect. That's good enough. So then 0 comma 5 halves. When y is 0, x is negative 5 over 3. And then I have negative 5 thirds comma 0. Let's stop for a moment. Let's stop for a moment and see if you have any questions. Any questions on this? Any questions on this? Are we okay? Mike, you have a question? Anyone? Any questions? Anyone? Okay, now I have to plot these two ordered pairs. 0 comma 5 halves is somewhere here, 2.5. This is 0 comma 5 halves. Now, 0 comma negative 5 thirds is close to negative 2. So somewhere here. Do I graph a solid line or not? A solid line. On the line, I write 3x minus 2y equals negative 5. Now, because the line does not pass through the origin, I can use the origin to check or test. So I have 0, 0, and I get 0 is greater than or equal to negative 5. Is that a true statement or a false statement? True. So I have to shade in the region where the origin is. Everything you see here in green represents 3x minus 2y greater than or equal to negative 5. Since this is a system, what do I have to do next? Exactly, where I have two colors. Do they overlap? Yes. Right here, this point, this line, this line, and of course everything in between. This will be both at the same time. Any questions on this problem? Any questions on this problem? I'm looking to see if we had any word problems that are not here in the review. So I don't want you to think that I did not review that on purpose. Nope, there is nothing here. Okay, so I'm moving on to chapter 10. At the end of chapter 10, review problems start on page 645. So that's pretty much it from chapter 9. So chapter 10 review starts with 1 through 159 pages 645 through 647. So let's look at least one problem from each section. Okay. At least, if not more. Page 645, I'm starting with 10.1. In 10.1, the following problems, all of them are important, but the following problems will be on your test for sure. 12, 14, 22, 25, 26. You choose. Fourteen. We have the cube root of 27y cubed divided by z to the 12th. One minute. Please redo all quizzes and homework and all problems we did in class. Ready? Can anyone dictate? The cube root of 27, the cube root of y cubed, the cube root of z to the 12th. First one is y over? Yeah, to the fourth power. Sorry, it's my z that works. Looks okay. Anything else from 12, 14, 22, 25, 26? 22, very good. Excellent. So this is the square root of 25, x minus y, everything squared. I'm really hoping you're going to do very well on this second test. We are using the entire time today to review everything. In this problem, we are told, use absolute value bars when necessary, which means x and y can be any real number. So, anyone wants to get this started? Which is? Very good. Anything else from 10.1? Simplify, use absolute value bars when necessary. Since the power is 1 on x minus y, and x and y can be anything, the answer can be negative, and it's not acceptable. Any even root is applied to positive or 0, and the answer is positive or 0. Anything else from these five problems?
25.
We have... In 25, f of x equals the square root of x plus 3. We're asked to find f of 0. And then we're asked to find f of 9. This is part A. F of 0, please. Shouldn't take that long. 3, very good. Now, f of 9, please.
6.
Very good. Square root of 9 is 9, 3, 3 plus 3 is 6. Part B. Find the domain of f of x. What do I have to write? Remember, we know how to graph four functions now. Linear, absolute value, square root, and cube root. We know all these four functions how to graph by now. So, first of all, we're asked about domain. We're not asked to graph it yet. So we're asked to find the domain. What do I have to write? I have to write something, solve that something, that will give me the domain. Then I will not be able to take the square root from it, if x is less than. Nope, the domain does not require the table. It's right here. It's an even root. So the quantity under that even root must be greater than or equal to 0. The quantity under the square root is x. I have to write x greater than or equal to 0. That inequality, since there is nothing to solve, I don't have to move, divide, anything, then that inequality alone gives us a domain. Can anyone tell us the domain? Okay. Anyone else? Oh, I'm sorry. Did you say negative infinity?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. Forgive me. I thought I heard negative infinity.
Saying so x is more than 0.
Right. So what did you
so
say?
It would be 0 to infinity.
Okay. For some reason, I heard negative infinity. Forgive me. My fault. My fault. Okay. In part C, we're asked to graph. Now, yes, that's what I'm going to do next. I need the chart. What is the domain? What do I have to put for x?
0.
Very good. So pick some numbers, and you must pick 0 first. So the function is f of x equals the square root of x plus 3. 2 will not be a good number. 3 will not, yes. 1 will be a good number, 4 will be a good number, and 9 will be a good number. So please plug in 0. You must start where the domain starts. Very good. Please plug in 1.
4.
Very good. Please plug in 4.
5.
Very good. Please plug in 9.
6.
That's all we need. So ready? So when x is 0, y is 3. Here it is. That's the first point. When x is 1, y is 4. That's the second point. 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on and so forth. Here's the graph. So this is the graph of f of x, the square root of x plus 3. When we change, John, when we change x, then there is a horizontal shift. Here we change y. From the square root of x, the square root of x plus 3, up 3. That's okay. Right, correct, correct. Okay, moving on to section 10.2. Let me select, for example, 33, 35, 44. 48, 56. Please choose.
44.
Okay, you want to start with 44. Where are you, 44? Okay, I see. So this is 44. B to 1/3 divided by B to 4/3. 1 minute.
Okay.
B to 1/3 over B to 4/3. B as in boy.
Yeah.
Raised to 1 over 3. Everything over B raised to 4 over 3.
Yes.
B as in boy.
Oh, negative B. Negative.
Negative.
Okay, you don't like B. Fine.
No.
Okay, so x to 1/3, that's okay, over x to 4/3. Forget about B. Everybody change from least to x. Same thing. Easier to write. Okay, copy the base. What do I have to write? No, I copy the base, and what do I do with the exponent? 1/3 minus 4/3. So this is x to which power? 1 minus 4 is negative 3 over 3. Negative 3 over 3 is negative 1. How much is x to negative 1?
Oh, it's 1 over x.
Thank you.
Because you got to do the fraction thing.
Sure.
Yeah, sorry.
Anything else in 10.2?
Yeah, can you warrant more of those problems?
Sure. This was 44. Let's do
48.
So we have x to 1/4, x to negative 1/2, over x to 2/3. 1 minute. Bless you. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
1/4.
Minus.
Excellent. I need the least common denominator. What is the least common denominator of 4, 2, and 3? Very good. So what is the adjustment for all three? But you're right, I will get 8. So what do I get? 3 times 1. Good. Perfect. So this is x. 6 minus 8 is negative 6 minus 8 is negative 14. Negative 14 plus 3 is negative 11. What does this represent? What does this represent? Rationalize, please. What do we rationalize by? Very good. I have to have the 12 root. Yes, that's all I'm missing. I'm missing 1x to perform to get the perfect 12. I have 11. I need one more. So the numerator is this, and the denominator will be indeed. Are we comfortable with this?
No.
Which part?
Once
after
we
finish it.
Yeah.
All of this.
Right.
I've memorized it.
So remember what you told me a minute ago to do with x to negative 1? Okay, so this is what we did.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, I know that every time I see a fraction as the exponent, it's a root.
Mm-hmm.
So now I know here that this is not rationalized,
yeah.
Right? I have to rationalize.
Mm-hmm.
So the 12 root times the 12 root of x to the 11 times x, this will be x to the 12th. When I take the square, the 12 root of x to the 12th, I get x. Better?
Yeah.
Everyone else, are you comfortable with this now? Okay. Anything else from 10.2 before we move on to 10.3?
56.
We have 105 raised to negative 2/3. The only thing I can do is punch it in the graphing calculator. So here's how I do that. I put 105. This is my preference. If you find the other ways, I'm happy. But this is my preference. Wake up. Okay. So in parentheses, 105 caret in parentheses, negative 2 divided by 3. Close the parentheses and enter. Normally, let's say it will take 4 decimal digits. 0.0449. Okay. Anything else from? Good. And write 3. Good. Can we move on to 10.3? Okay, 10.3. Making a selection here. 62, 68, 72, 76, 79, 86. Which one we start with? And 62, we have the fourth root of a to the sixth b to the 13th. Everything divided by the fourth root of a squared b. Can anyone give us an idea of what to do? The starting point. Of course, you have to use or write one radical. Why? Can anyone explain why would I do this? Common factors. They have common factors. Very good. Excellent. Ready? Can anyone tell us what we have under the fourth root? A to the fourth. Do you all agree with A to the fourth and B to the 12th?
Yes.
And then I will have the fourth root of A to the fourth times the fourth root of B to the 12th. Assuming, maybe that's not the case, I didn't even read the requirement. Assume A and B can be any real number. This is my assumption. This is what I edit in right now. So then, is it?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. So what is the fourth root of A to the fourth?
A.
Careful. No, I changed that to can be any real number. The absolute value of A times. Very good. So now you can say, I can say, so this will be AB to the third if A and B are positive or zero. Very good. Anything else? Next problem.
So that's the final answer.
If the A and B can be any real number, this is the final answer. If A and B can be only positive numbers, this is the final answer. Good. Next question.
Seventy-two.
We need 68 or not?
Yeah.
So 68, the cube root of 24, a to the fifth, b to the seventh. Sorry about that. B to the seventh. Can anyone tell us what to do here? Yes. So first I'm going to write the cube root of 24, the cube root of a to the fifth, and the cube root of b to the seventh. They're all ugly, right? Because I can't take the cube root from anything. So what do I do? Okay, this is 3 and 8, I agree. This is, and this is, very good. You can rewrite, or I should say, you can write the intermediate step, which will be this. The cube root of 3, the cube root of 8, the cube root of a cubed, the cube root of a squared, the cube root of b to the sixth, and the cube root of b. Which of these factors will not have the cube root on them at the end? The first one will keep the cube root or not? Will the second one keep the cube root? No, this will become? Will the next one keep the cube root? No, this will become? Will this one keep the cube root? What about this one? This will become? So the simplified form is then, so 2a, b squared, and the cube root of this, which is 3, this, which is a squared, and this, which is b. Okay, 72. Any questions on this problem? Now, since we are reviewing everything, you must go back and redo all problems we did in class. Oh, and I promised a lecture, and I didn't even go through the lecture from before. I promised to give you the lecture. Oops, I forgot. Okay, so 72. Let me copy 72, and then I'll look for it. Yes. So 2x cubed divided by 49y to the fourth. Which one you said? 86. Very good. And then we move on. So this was from Monday, correct? This is what I'm looking for, right?
Yeah.
And yes, I would like to go over this for a moment and then give it to Z. Okay, ready? The square root of 2, the square root of x cubed, the square root of 49, the square root of y to the fourth. The denominator is very simple, clear. What is it? Now, how do I present the cube, the square root of x cubed? What do I have to do to that? Good. So please give me the numerator. So x, the square root of 2x. Very good. That was 72. Any questions on 72, please? Okay, before we do 86, let me just remind you what we covered last time. So we looked at this quiz that I just returned, and then we looked at radical equations, and we worked a lot on radical equations, and I have a lot of notes in there. This changes into a quadratic. I have to set it equal to 0. And then I have to factor. Then this was a difficult situation with two radicals. I'm not going to put this as mandatory on a test, but you may have it as an extra credit. Okay. Same, this is with one radical. Yes, we have to isolate the radical. This was two radicals, but no other term connected to them. So that was not a difficult situation. Here we had to isolate the radical first. Here we know how to apply the Pythagorean theorem. We know the principle of taking square roots now. And remember, when you take square roots, we omit this step. By omitting this step, it doesn't mean that the square root of 4 is plus or minus 2. The signs, the two symbols come from this side. Okay, I think something else is more important. So then we solved triangles, determining either a leg or the hypotenuse. And then we talked about complex numbers, and we said that I is the imaginary unit. And why was the reason, what was the reason why we needed to invent complex numbers is because we could not solve this equation. Because we cannot take the square root from negative 4. So then we split the square root of negative 4 into negative, the square root of negative 1 times the square root of 4, and that became 2i. And then we learned how to add, subtract, multiply, divide complex numbers. We'll have examples right now. And then we looked at powers of I. There is a formula in the book. I don't recommend it, but if you want to remember a formula, that's fine too. What I normally do, I show my students, is that any an I to raised to any power can be written somehow in terms of I squared. And we'll have a couple of examples today. So that was last time. One more time, I will redo each and every problem. You have the video lecture. So if you get stuck, you can always watch it. Okay, 86. 86 in 10, 3. And that is the square root of 3, comma, negative 2, the square root of 6. And the square root of 3, comma, negative 4, the square root of 6. And we're asked here just to find the midpoint. So finding the midpoint requires us to determine the average, calculate the average of x's. So the square root of 3 plus the square root of 3 everything over 2 will be 2 the square root of 3 over 2, which is the square root of 3 when you simplify by 2.
What?
An apple, one apple plus one apple is 2 apples. When I divide, I simplify by 2 and I get the square root of 3. Similarly, with negative 2, the square root of 6 minus 4, the square root of 6, everything over 2. Negative 2 apples minus 4 apples is negative 6 apples divided by 2. I'll simplify and I get negative 3. Negative 3, the square root of 6. So this is the midpoint. The square root of 3, comma, negative 3, the square root of 6. Moving on to 10-4. I only have 25 minutes and I have few more sections to cover or review. So 10.4, 90, 93, 94, 100, 101. Let me list the rest because in case we don't get to all of them, at least you have the idea. So this is from 10.4. From 10.5, 108, 110, 114. And from 10-6, all of them, 117 through 120. I would say not 120, 121. Okay, not 122. And 125, 126. And the last one in 10.7, I recommend 130, 132, 137, 132. I don't see a problem here like the one I need, and I'm going to edit here. 2 plus 3i over 4 minus 2i. I don't see a problem like this over there. And I to the 4th, I to the 7th, I to 101. I recommend chapter 10, test, all of them. All the answers are in the back. So all 1 through 38, page 647, 648. Okay, so let's choose 10-4, 10-5, 10-6, 10-7. Anything from 10-4? A 101. 101. Very good. 101, we have the cube root of 5x plus 9 multiplied by the cube root of 5x minus 9. I recommend the formula here because it's a plus b times a minus b, and this is the third contract. Of course, if you want to FOIL, please do so. 1 minute. Ready? The first term squared is the cube root of 25x squared. Very good. Minus the second term squared, which is 81. Let's look at problem 121. In 121, we have 2x minus 5 to the square root of x equals 3. Let's think for a moment. 1 minute. Okay, any suggestions for me, please? Move the, exactly, move the
2x.
Right. Here's what I recommend. Because the radical has minus in front, I would prefer doing this, but it's not a mistake if you move the 2x. So I have 2x minus 3 equals 5 the square root of x. I recommend this. Instead of having a negative in front of a radical, who knows what I'm going to do with it. So now, next step, please. So the first step required us to isolate the radical. Are you all in agreement with this first step? Yes, everyone? Okay, perfect. Now what do I do? Please, square both sides. Remember to use the contract on the first one. You cannot combine like terms because 5 is multiplied by x.
So
you cannot break the relationship between negative 5 and x and the square of x. The left-hand side, can anyone dictate the left-hand side? Yes, 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 3 is 12. Very good, 12x. Careful, the last term is only, yes. In the expansion of the something squared, binomial squared, the last term is always positive. But however, don't confuse it with a plus b times a minus b, which has minus in between. Very good. So plus 9. The right-hand side, very good. Indeed, 25x. So what do I do next? So that's minus 37x and plus 9 equals 0. Okay. So now, if you remember, we did something similar last time. Because the leading coefficient is not 1, this is the product of the numbers I need. And this is the sum. So I need two numbers whose product is, can anyone give us the product? Which is? Yes, this is not a huge number, so I'm going to write 36. And the same numbers whose sum is? Good. Now, the numbers, the product is positive. What type of numbers, if I have two numbers exactly, and I multiply them, and I get a positive product. What type of numbers are they?
Positive.
Either both positive or both negative. But their sum is negative. Then I know for sure they must be negative.
-1 and -3.
Very good. -1 and -36. Excellent. But now I have to go back and rewrite the whole thing. 4x squared, instead of negative 37x, what do I write? Very good. Negative 36x plus 9. If I forget what follows here, then I will never solve for anything. Equals 0. And now I will factor. So from the first two, what will I factor out?
X.
What is left in parentheses?
4x.
What do I have to get from the other two, otherwise I cannot continue?
4x.
And then I need a symbol, either plus or minus, and a factor. What is the symbol? Oh, it would be negative, and what do I need? Let's check. Very good. Negative 9 times 4x is negative 36x. Negative 9 times negative 1 is positive 9. Excellent. Now I pull out the common factor. Can anyone give us the common factor that we need to pull out? Very good. This is the common factor. And what is left in parentheses? X minus 9. So there are two options. X equals, x equals. Very good. Good. But look at this. What am I getting at? I have to. And here's the original problem. I have to copy the original problem. Here it is. 2x minus 5, the square root of x equals 3. I am checking 9 first. How much is the square root of 9? How much is 3 times 5? With minus in front. So this is 18 minus 15. Does this equal 3? So I will say yes for 9. Now I'm checking 1/4. How much is the square root of 1/4? The square root of 1 over 4 is the square root of 1 over the square root of 4, which we know it's good, times negative 5. So this will be negative 5 over 2. This is 2 times 1 over 4. 2 times 1 over 4, I simplify. So I get 1/2. How much is 1/2 minus 5 over 2? It's negative 4 over 2, which is negative 2. So do you accept this? No. Very good. Okay, let's look at some eyes. Yes, please. Okay. What do you mean? Have I ever missed one? As soon as possible. But I haven't missed one yet. Yet. I hope I don't. Okay, let's look at some I's. For example, I to 101. I to 101 is I times I to 100. So instead of I to 100, I will write I squared to a power. What power? Very good. So this is I multiplied by negative 1 to the 50th power, because we know I squared is negative 1. So negative 1 to the 50th power is? Right. Right. A negative number raised to an even power will always be a positive number, and since it's 1, it's 1. So the answer is I. Let's divide two complex numbers, and I picked, what did I pick? 2 plus 3i over 4 minus 2i. Yes, yes, yes. No, no, I said this. I to any power on the planet can have one of the following four answers. 1, negative 1, I, or negative I. Yes? Yes. So work on this, please. Divide these two. 2 plus 3i by 4 minus 2i, and I'll make one up for you. So that the answer is negative I. Okay. So what are we going to do when we divide complex numbers? The conjugate. Can anyone give us the conjugate of the denominator? The denominator uses our third contract, and the middle sign has to be negative in the middle. So can anyone give us the denominator? Now the numerator has to be FOIL'd. I have no choice. So 2 times 4 is 2 times 2i, 3i times 4, and 3i times 2i. Very good. But now we know that I squared has to be replaced by negative 1. So please tell me what to write. Knowing that 6 times negative 1 is negative 6. 8 minus 6. 8 from the front here and minus 6 here. 2. 4i plus 12i. Good. Now 4 is negative. Negative 4 times negative 1. Negative 4 times negative 1 is 4 plus 16. Good. I will have to separate, as we know. 2 over 20 plus 16 over 20i, and I will simplify. And I will get 1 over 10 plus, simplified by 4, 4 over 5i. And this is the final answer. Okay, now here's the question. I to the 7th, it's I to the 6th times I. I to the 6th is I squared to the 3rd times I. But I squared is negative 1 to the 3rd times I. Negative 1 to the 3rd is? Good. Times I. Negative I. Better? Good. Okay, we have 7 minutes left. So let's see what else was on the list. Oh, yes, let's do 94. 2a, the fourth root of 32b to the fifth, minus 3b, the fourth root of 162a to the 4th b, plus the 4th root of 2a to the 4th b to the 5th. This is a long problem. Why? Can anyone explain why? Each and every radical needs to be fully simplified. Can anyone dictate the first one? It's 2a, and then this has many steps. It's a long process. The fourth root of 32 times the fourth root of b to the fifth minus 3b, the fourth root of, very good, the fourth root of b plus the 4th root of 2, the 4th root of a to the 4th, and the 4th root of b to the 5th. Let's identify the radicals that are nice, and we don't have to worry about them. Is there anything that is nice here? That's it. This is nice, and this is nice. Now let's identify the ones that I don't have to work on at all, because I can simplify them. The 4th root of 2 and the 4th root of b. Everything else I need to work on. I need to work on the 4th root of 32. I need to work on the 4th root of b to the 5th, but I have it doubled here, so that's not that bad. So 1, 2, with this repeat here, and 3. I only have 3 radicals to work on. This, this, and this. Okay? So let's start with b to the 5th. How will you break down b to the 5th? And b. The same thing here. B to the 4th and b. Now let's look at 32. I need to rewrite 32 as... I can't because it's the 4th root. 8 and 4 are not perfect 4th. But... Exactly. Thank you. Indeed, 16 and 2. So this will be broken up into 16 and 2. The last one is 162. So I know that 162 is an even number, so it's divisible by the first prime number, which is 2, and then that's 81. And I know 81. 81 is a perfect fourth. So 162 changes into 2 and 81. Now I'm going to write everything again. Make sure I don't miss anything. And so start from 2a. 2a. The 4th root of 16. The 4th root of 2. This is the 4th root of b to the 4th and the 4th root of b. Do we all understand the first radical?
Yes.
Do we all agree with the first radical? Everyone? Okay, so now minus 3b, then I have the 4th root of 2, the 4th root of 81. Now this is done, it's a. And now the 4th root of b, and then plus the 4th root of 2, this is a, and this is the 4th root of b to the 4th, and this is the 4th root of b. Any questions so far? Is this clear? So now, what else will be free of radicals from the very first one? What will be free of radicals? This will be free of radicals. This will be free of radicals. From the second one, what will be free of radicals? And from the last one, what will be free of radicals? That's it. Everything else will stay. So how much is the 4th root of 16? 2 multiplied by the 2 in front, 4. So I have 4ab, 4ab, and the 4th root of 2b. The 2 times the 2, and a and b. And the 4th root of 2 times the 4th root of b. Minus. From the second radical, only a 3 comes out. But it needs to be multiplied by the 3 in front. So it's negative. And a, right? Negative 9ab, the 4th root of 2b. And plus, last one, just b goes in front. So a and b. And this is the 4th root of 2b. So all this work, I analyze to see if these are like radicals. Yes, yes, yes. Same variables in front, same powers for those variables. So I have 4 plus 1, which is 5. 5 minus 4 minus 9 is negative 4. Any questions?